Today we had the opportunity to have here at Ulm University Professoressa Dear McCloskey. Our student could listen and discuss with her about the new tendency in economics, the many critics that people are making to the economical theories, and the capacity of the economist to predict the future and also to influence the decision of the policymakers in terms of quality of life, of income, of availability of consumption. So, before starting a discussion, I would like to listen to you, an opinion for you. It was famous when Queen Elizabeth II went to London School of Economics and she asked to a huge number of very well-known economists, how haven't you been able to predict the disaster? So what's your opinion?
Well, my answer is very simple. Humans are not molecules, and so they have their own opinion, and so they move around in ways that are unpredictable. And indeed, if we knew, as well as the meteorologists know, how to predict the future, we economists would all be rich, and I'm not rich.
You wrote about the virtues of the bourgeoisie in some way in conflict with the way the economists are working today. What's your position about that?
The way economists treat the borghese is as maximizers. They're maximizing profit. And I don't think that's how people in business actually operate. Of course, they're interested in profit, but they're also interested in the other virtues of a human being. And it's crucial that we who are not in business think of them as complete human beings. You need to treat your employees with a certain amount of love and a certain amount of temperance and justice.
You are also a professor of communication.
I am indeed.
So I would like to go into the field of communication. We are here in the University of Communication. What's your view and your opinion about this new scandal of the misuse of the data from the social media and all the debate about how privacy could be preserved? Is it still possible in an open society as we are to maintain a privacy?
Well, it's becoming harder and harder. In olden days, with no good means of communication, you could live a private life very easily. I think there's a role for the government in preventing, say, Facebook from not doing its duty and saving the privacy. But indeed, I think Facebook itself will do a great deal. I think Facebook is ashamed at the way its data has been used.
Now a question about the future. How do you imagine the evolution of the artificial intelligence, and what are the possible impacts on the economy and on the society?
In fact, we don't know. We couldn't have predicted the effect of the steam engine on society, much less artificial intelligence. But I think what artificial intelligence can do is take away some of the routine jobs of our society and leave us with the matters of judgment and creativity, which we can't get from a machine. So I don't think there's going to be mass unemployment as a result of artificial intelligence. I think that way, there have been 200 years of very rapid technological change, and it's never resulted in permanent unemployment. So I'm an optimist. I'm a liberal and an optimist.
So dear, thank you so much for these words you are granting us. And I really understand now that you are really not only an economist, nor a professor of English, of culture, nor a social scientist, but you are a philosopher. And what we need in today's world full of complexity is philosopher. So thank you so much for your support and your activity.
Grazie mille.